Hey guys, so it's another Wednesday and we're back in Africa. I'm actually coming at you from home today because I want to talk to you guys about something that we can all work on at home with our riding, and you don't really have to be at the cable necessarily to think about this and how it can improve your riding, and that is handle control. I've noticed, you know, just from the beginning of doing these tutorials that we got over handle control quite a bit. And it's such an important thing, and it's so easy in wakeskating especially to get distracted by everything that's happening under your feet, all the flips and spins and shoves, that we forget about what our hands are doing. And at the end of the day, if I can explain handle control in the best way, or the best way for you, it is, imagine if I took a rope and I tied it around your shoulders and I pulled you from your shoulders, you're more than likely going to fall over forwards. Whereas if I took that rope and I tied it around your waist and I pulled you, I'd pull your whole body forward with your core. That's exactly what we're looking for in handle control. Is we do not want the rope up here. We don't want the rope too low either, or we don't want our arms too straight. We just want our arms to effectively be an extension, or be that rope around our waist, so that we are getting pulled. Our whole body's getting pulled from the center, which at the end of the day gives us a lot of balance. It really is an important thing, but it's something that we all do struggle with, and you know, sometimes forget to focus on. I think when I think about handle control in wakeskating, I can only think about, you know, one name that comes to mind is Nick Taylor. He has such good handle control on all his spins, most of his tricks. You know, I'll play a couple of clips now and you'll just see, like, this back three, he's just got the handle in the right place and he just makes it look a lot easier than it is. And, you know, I'm probably not the best example for handle control, but I have picked up a lot on it, and I think I can definitely help you guys just fall a lot less and learn a lot quicker if you are focusing on your rope. So the first thing I just wanted to do was show you a clip of me here on a frontside flip where I completely kind of duff the handle and I lift my arms up. More importantly, because I'm on the cable and I can't get the rope as low as I normally do on, say, the jet ski or the boat, I want you to look at my elbow, because when you're getting pulled up like that, the next thing closest to your waist is going to be your elbow, because obviously on the cable you can't get it as low as a havoc chair or behind a jet ski. So watch as I land how my elbow goes out and up, and then you'll see that even though the board and everything flip perfectly, just because of my handle control I go completely off, and yeah, it just doesn't look good at all. Whereas if I show you the next clip and you look at my elbow and you look at the handle positioning as I come down to land, it just makes everything look a lot easier and you know, a lot better. I'm in way more control. I'm ready to right away switch. I'm ready to actually pass the handle into my other hand. So that's like a very big basic, especially for anyone who's riding the cable. I think a lot of people hear the handle low thing and they're like, oh, how do I do this? Like, I'm getting pulled up, I can't get the rope that low. So like you'll see on a couple of cable clips, even just the straight ollie, you'll see the handle's still quite high, but my elbow's in and nice and tight, and that's what's helping me keep my balance. Once again, also using a lot of strength from more probably my bicep than my forearm, by pulling that rope nice and in and getting my elbow in for the trick. Yeah, like I said, check this ollie clip out, see where my arm is there, and then you'll see here on a couple of the jet ski clips from a Istudiomo that obviously then I'm allowed to bring my hand a lot lower and the actual physical handle lower for a few of these tricks. You know, those are really some basics that you might find are the only reason you're falling on the next trick that you're trying. I remember doing, you know, when you do like a back three or any of those tricks off kickers and stuff, often just lifting the rope makes you fall over, and it even happens on a straight forward trick too. It really is an easy mistake to make, and something you, throughout your career or throughout wakeskating, you will have to kind of try adjust for different tricks, because the handle and your arms are always moving when you are going in a different rotation, and your feet to some extent do affect what your upper body does. So yeah, I think for handle control, you know, that pretty much does it. Just wanted to point out a couple of the basics. A few mistakes just to look out for when you are trying to work on your handle control is obviously try not to pull the rope in. You know, we teach you that from the beginning to, you know, kind of keep your arms straight or your arms locked, because as soon as you pull the rope in, you're just pulling your lower body out from underneath you. So that's a big one, and that's often, you think once you're riding you don't make the mistake anymore, but you'll be surprised how often when you land a trick, all of a sudden you go into that, like, it's almost second nature or instinctive to just want to pull the rope in. So that's definitely one big mistake to look at. One is also trying to keep the rope like really close into your waist. You still want your arms out a little bit and locked like this. You still want to be able to get that leverage where when you do a spin trick, you can pull in and get the handle close or just keep that strength in your bicep. Whereas when you're down here, you don't really have much strength in your arms. You kind of rely completely on your back. A lot of the time I find people are doing, they're doing ollies as well. They try and jump with the handle. So you'll see on, I'll switch to an ollie clip now. And in that ollie clip too, you'll see I keep my arm in, keeping that elbow close to my body in. But we'll obviously delve into stuff like handle passes and stuff in another stage. That's a whole other aspect of handle control. But these are the basics of handle control, and these I guarantee will speed up your progression if you work on them. It will allow you to, you know, fall less. It'll also allow you to kind of break down tricks yourself a lot easier. So if you can at home, tie a handle to a tree, get used to where it needs to be for certain tricks. Another good example too, or something to do, is maybe tie a bit of a weight on the end of the handle, swing it around. That gets you used to the feeling of where the handle should be. And then next time you ride, get on the water, just focus and feel out where you need or where you feel comfortable with that handle and where you can feel the different points of balance when you are on the cable or behind the boat or the ski. Like I said, I think it's something a lot of us as wake skaters kind of forget about, because we're so worried about the three flips and the big flips and the, okay, maybe, you know, that for me, that's what I often find worrying about. But to, you know, to try to talk on everyone's level, even from a shove or something like that, you get so worried about all these tricks that you forget about what your arms are doing. So next time you ride, just pay a little bit more attention to where the handle is on every trick you do, and just see how moving it and putting it in the right place adjusts it. You know, even on a front 180, or if you look at the frontside flip again, when I move it across my hip, how it helps me do the 180, all of that stuff is really important, and stuff we'll delve into deeper when we do the actual tricks themselves. But this was just a broad tutorial on handle control. So yeah, right guys, and now that you are understanding handle control more, I think it's time, you know, to start working on your ollies, try to get those ollies a little bit bigger, and subscribe so we can work on more flat tricks for the next couple weeks. Thank you so much for joining me, and we'll see you guys next week for another Wakeskate Wednesday.